actor DJ is. I guess I'll have to start the show by myself.
Wait, I'm here. Oh!
Thank goodness, Dr. DJ, you're here. I couldn't do it without the man.
Of course. So what's the next segue?
Well, the first up, we have movie reviews. How's that?
Movie reviews?
Let's watch them.
Roll them.
Hi, I'm Chris. You ever have trouble picking out the right movie? Well, I'm here to help you. I picked out some of my favorite recent movies. The first one's Face Off. It's a great action, starring John Travolta and Nicolas Cage.
We've got something in common.
We both know our guns.
What we don't have in common is that I don't care if I live, and you do.
Sean,
that hurts. You're not having any fun, are you, Sean?
Hello, Sasha.
When was the last time you saw Castor Troy?
Who cares?
I don't know what I hate wearing worse, your face or your body.
My next movie, Men in Black, starring Tommy Lee Jones and Will Smith.
Looks like you fell off the bus in the wrong part of town, amigo. In fact, I'm going to bet dollars to pesos you're not from anywhere near here. Come on.
It'd just be raining black people in New York.
What's up? Back in the mid-1950s, the government started a little underfunded agency with the simple and laughable purpose of establishing contact with the race none of this planet.
If you look directly at the end of this device, we'll administer the eye test.
Everybody thought the agency was a joke, except the aliens who made contact March 2, 1961, outside New York. There were nine of us the first night. Seven agents, one astronomer, and one dumb kid who got lost on the wrong back road.
Oh, you brought that tall man some flowers.
1,500 years ago, everybody knew the Earth was the center of the universe. 500 years ago, everybody knew the Earth was flat. And 15 minutes ago, you knew that people were alone on this planet.
This movie contains great effects, makeup, costumes. Just take a look.
Is that Leonard?
How you doing, fellas?
Oh, shit. Okay.
That's not decaf, is it?
Viennese cinnamon.
We are the Men in Black.
You know what the difference is between you and me? I make this look good.
Hey, those movies look really good.
Yeah, let's make it a blockbuster night. Say, Patty, my girlfriend's birthday's coming up soon, and I'm broke, and I have no idea what to get her. What should I do?
Why don't you make her some hemp jewelry?
Hemp jewelry? Ah. I don't know how.
Let a woman show you what to do.
Okay.
If you take a look at most of the teenagers in the area, you'll notice they have one thing in common, hemp jewelry. Necklaces and bracelets can all be made out of industrialized hemp cord. Another trend that people are following is to make their own jewelry rather than to buy it. That's exactly what I'm going to show you how to do today. All you need to make yourself some hemp jewelry is a ball of 1 millimeter hemp cord, wooden glass or plastic beads, scissors, and tape. These supplies can be found at craft or bead supply stores. The first step to making the jewelry is to learn to tie the knot. There is one basic knot, the half knot. To start your piece, tie three strands together with an overhand knot. Secure the knot to the table with a piece of tape. Secure the center strand, or the green strand, to the table with tape. Bring the right strand underneath the center strand. Put the left strand underneath the right strand. over the center strand, and through the loop formed by the right and center strands. To add a bead, put the bead on one of the strands and keep tying knots as usual. When it gets to the length you desire, tie it around your neck or wrist, and now you have a brand new piece of trendy jewelry.
Wow, Patty, that was a great idea. A gift from the heart is always appreciated.
Let's kick back and watch a music video now.
Oh, that sounds good.
Reluctantly crouched at the starting line, engines pumping and thumping in time. The green light flashes, the flags go up. Churning and burning, they yearn for the cup. They deftly maneuver and muscle for rank. Fuel burning fast on an empty tank. Reckless and wild, they pour through the turns. Their prowess is potent and secretly stern. As they speed through the finish, the flags go down. The fans get up and they get out of town. The arena is empty except for one man, still driving and striving as fast as he can. The sun has gone down and the moon has come up. And long ago somebody left with the cup. But he's driving and striving and hugging the turns and thinking of someone for whom he still burns. He's going the distance. He's going for speed. She's all alone in a time of need. Because he's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and fighting and riding on his horse. He's going the distance. Assail him, impale him with monster truck force. In his mind, he's still driving, still making the grade. She's hoping in time that her memories will fade. Cause he's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and fighting and riding on his horse. The sun has gone down and the moon has come up. And long ago, somebody left with the cup. But he's striving and driving and hugging the turns and thinking of someone for whom he still burns. Cause he's going the distance.
Talking about, you didn't even see it, you were down there.
Oh,
and when you fell, you hit my leg, and now it hurts.
Well, I got just the video for you. Let's watch.
Call Dr. DJ, he'll be racing. He'll be there with no delay. Call Dr. DJ, he'll be racing. He'll be there a night or day. Whenever you need him, he'll be ready to give you a helping hand. Dr. DJ loves the children and helps the poor all across the land. Call on Dr. DJ, call on Dr. DJ today. Calling Dr. DJ, calling Dr. DJ. Dr. DJ is the man, Dr. DJ is the man.
help. I need a doctor. My daughter's hurt. Please help us.
I'm a doctor.
We like doctors.
We like her.
Please help her.
We need Dr. DJ.
We need Dr. DJ.
Oh, Dr.
Hey, Dr. Okay.
Help. I like her.
Take her into the emergency room, and I'll come with her mother.
Okay. All right, let's go.
Oh, Dr. DJ, she fell. I don't know what's wrong.
Okay, okay, come on, I'll talk to you here. Hi, Miss Dora.
Yes, Dr. DJ.
Don't worry about your daughter's condition. She's in good hands with me. Now, if you make yourself comfortable, I'll be back in a few moments to brief you on her condition.
My leg hurt! It just hurt!
What happened here?
Her leg.
Get her ass stabilized, get her feet stabilized. We need to move quick, boys. Take her heart rate. Our scene's beginning, all right? We need to use, let me use your arm. Try to remain calm, please. Try to remain calm. It's a simple process I'm gonna take. All right, that's good. We need to proceed to operating. Keep her leg stabilized. Can you tell me what happened?
I hurt my leg.
How did you hurt your leg?
I don't know.
All right, hold her leg. We need to put her to sleep, guys. Hold her, stabilize her. Please remain still while I put this to your arm. Show your arm, please. I'm gonna count from five, from one to five backwards. Five. 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, she just relaxed. Now, let me check a little more. That was pretty bad. It smells so good.
We're hot dogs, Dr. DJ.
Hot dogs. There's a patient in need of our assistance. Come. Put the food down. How can we forget about her? What did we do? We must check her leg. Oh no. We're too late. Who's gonna tell her mother? Me. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up!
My leg hurt!
Boys, we might have to amputate. Give me 15 cc's of 200 milligram Amputed.
My leg hurt!
Excuse me, man.
My leg hurt!
Remain still.
My leg
remain still, please! Yeah, you hungry?
Yeah?
Hot dog, please.
Here you go, Dr. DJ.
Here you go. Okay, that'll leave her stabilized. Give me the cord that will inject her to make her go back to sleep, please. Thank you. Now, put this arm down. Shut your eyes and relax. Please. Can we have her stabilized now? We must amputate. Jason, stabilize her.
Hi, Ms. Dora.
Yes, Dr. DJ.
Due to an acute infection in your daughter's femur, we were forced to amputate her leg.
But it was only a broken leg, Dr. DJ. You amputated her leg?
Even though I'm the man, there was nothing I could do to help her. Now, if you please take this bill and read it over, you can sign it on the way to the emergency room while we go visit your daughter. Please come with me.
My God! Her leg! Courtney!
Dr. DJ, he'll be racing. He'll be there with no delay. Call Dr. DJ, he'll be racing. He'll be there a night or day. Whenever you need him, he'll be ready to give you a helping hand. Dr. DJ loves the children and helps the poor all across the land. Calling Dr. DJ, call on Dr. DJ, call on Dr. DJ today.
It's the truth. I'm living testimony to the fact that what these guys are telling you is true. Now, when young people say it's not going to happen to them, you're not the only ones who fall into that lie. Parents do it too. Not my kid. My kid won't do that. Parents, your kid can do that. And in a lot of cases, your kids...
Hi, I'm Courtney Redman in the public meeting room of the municipal building with Mayor Ajax Ackerman. How are you doing today, Ajax?
I'm fine, Courtney. How are you?
I'm pretty good. So tell us, why did you choose to run for council in the first place?
Like I say, I chose to run for council because I could. As I went through college and grew up and did a number of things, I got a lot of messages from people telling me what I couldn't do. And I realized that I could do anything I wanted to do. If I put my mind to it. And since I was qualified to run for council, I did. And as a result of running for council, I got the most votes and they appointed me mayor. Surprise, surprise.
Can you tell us some of the duties of mayor that you have?
Well, the duties of mayor are primarily ceremonial. It is an appointed position, not necessarily elected position. So, for instance, I'll run the council meeting. My job is chairman of council. I will also represent the city in international and state functions. I represent the city at meetings and other various functions. And I'm allowed to marry people within the boundaries of the city of Port Huron.
Well, that's nice. Do you have a job other than mayor that you...
Other jobs outside of mayor, I am the wraparound aide for community mental health. And I am also the executive director of Clear Choices, which is a youth alternative program in Port Huron.
I see. Do you enjoy doing that type of things?
Yeah, everything I do, I enjoy it because it's community involvement. Everything I do in my life is about community and other people. I'm real strong on human issues and keeping people together.
I think that's one of the reasons that they elected you to be mayor, that you got a lot of votes, is because you're very involved with the community.
Well, I like to believe that community involvement is one of the hallmarks of citizenship. It's not my community, it's our community. And community means a whole group of people working together for a common good.
There's a lot of, there's been a lot of city council meetings going on within the past, let's say, a month or so. Mm-hmm. Do you have a lot of visions for Port Huron and the future, what's going to be going on?
My long-range visions for the city of Port Huron, and understanding that I could be gone in 2 years, my long-range goals would probably be that Port Huron become a tourist destination for not only people from around the state, but from around the country and Canada as well. Port Huron is the center of the Blue Water area, has a great deal of natural resources to draw from, and I don't believe that we've ever really taking advantage of those natural resources other than having the Mackinac race. So I see us positioning ourselves to become a really strong tourist destination over the next 10 to 20 years.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot of attractions that people could come here and see and visit. What's the hardest part of being mayor? I know you have a lot of priorities and things that you have to
The hardest
do.
Part of being mayor is juggling. Mayor is typically a volunteer position. And historically, mayors don't spend that great deal of time doing city business. I don't know how to do that, so I spend a great deal of time doing city business, and as a result, I have to juggle my personal life, my work schedule, and city business to try to fit it all in a 24-hour period. That's probably the hardest thing to do.
Recently, you went to Washington, D.C. to mm-hmm. visit Senator Levin. Mm-hmm. Can you tell us what happened there? Did you have a good time?
Oh, I had a great time. Senator Levin was very wonderful. Senator Levin invited us into his office. And, you know, the nice thing about Washington, well, let me backtrack. One of the misconceptions about Washington is that it's real stodgy and formal and, you know, typically conservative by its appearance.
Mm-hmm.
And when we were brought into Senator Levin's office, he sat my wife and I down, and he flopped down on the couch and said, "Let's talk." And it was real laid back and real relaxed. And we got some commitments from Senator Levin to help us in the projects that we're working on in the city of Port Huron. And then he gave me a tour of the dome, which was really exciting, a little private access to places people mm-hmm. don't normally get to see. Washington was a real adventure. It was real exciting to represent our community at the national level. So.
How many days did you end up spending there?
4 days.
4 days?
In Washington, yes.
That's nice. Just you and your wife went?
And two other council people.
That's nice. Okay, there's been this big controversy. I know you're going to love this part. Of your beard and your hair. Can you explain to us why exactly you wear that style? I mean, is it how you've always been, or?
Always been.
Always been.
Always been. I believe growing up as a teenager, when I went to military academy when I was young, and I got out of the military academy when I was 14, and I hated cutting my hair. I hated getting a haircut every 2 weeks, and so I swore I never would do it again. Realistically, I've gotten a few haircuts in my life, but I've always hated getting them. And I wear my hair long and I wear my beard because I can. Not unlike young people of today who want to be known for who they are. They don't want to be one of the crowd. I am who I am. And my hair, my beard identifies me as that. So I get to play with it. And it, you know, some little nervous habit stuff, you know. But it is who I am. And if I was to shave my hair and my beard off to run for political office, then you would know I was lying. That you would believe, and rightly so, that I was playing a game with you. That I was trying to manipulate you just to get this position. And I'm not going to do that. You will either accept me for who I am, or you will reject me for who I am. But I'm not going to give any false fronts to anybody.
Myself, and I'm probably speaking for a lot of people, probably can't imagine you with shorter hair either, too.
It's been there.
I heard that you have this sewage scenario going on. They have this rumor going around that if they pass it, then you're going to cut your hair off. Is that true?
Well, the truth on that story, One of the reporters from the local radio station asked me if I would cut my hair off if we got the sewer thing going. We got into a discussion, and I said, if you can privately raise $186 million to pay for the separation of sewers so that the citizens don't have to pay it, I will gladly shave my beard and shave my head.
That's a very low, what am I trying to say here? It's a very low chance that they're going to be able to raise $180 million.
I'm not a gambler, so anytime you hear me taking a bet, it's a sure thing I'm going to win.
Let's see here. We heard that you were in a motorcycle magazine. About a month ago?
March 31st, this month, Easy Rider is doing an article on myself and the fact that a biker is a mayor now. It's like, one of ours does good, so they're going to put a little spread in that.
How far are they going to go into detail about your background, or are they just going to do a little arc or put you on the front of the magazine?
I don't believe I'll be on the cover.
No.
I don't believe I'll be the cover boy.
That'd be nice if you were on the cover.
I don't think that Easy Rider's ever had a guy on the cover. tell you the truth. They're going to probably use most of the information from the article that was written in the Times Herald. And they'll probably add some editorial comment in themselves. But other than that, it'll probably be a pretty generic article.
Do you have any idea what issues that's going to be on?
March 31st. So I believe that the issue's coming out March 31st.
Okay.
It's probably the June issue or something. They come out a couple months ahead.
I see. Some people would like to see you going further into politics. Do you have any plans for that, or would you like to go further up, or as mayor, as far as you're going to go?
I would love to be in Washington. What a great town. No, I have no ambitions today. Today I am the mayor. I'm a city council person. I have a job in front of me, and I need to do that. I feel real strongly that I've made a commitment to the citizens to do that job, and that should the time arise and the situation arise, the citizens want me to go to another level of government, they will ask me, and at that point, my family and I will consider doing that.
Well, good luck to you as mayor and beyond, and thank you for joining me here today.
Thank you, Courtney.